Welcome back to Speller Tutorial Services. Today we're going to continue with our talk in vectors. Again, we're going to do another application problem, and I'm going to show some different techniques with the trig functions and some different negative angles to solve this particular problem. Alright, so let's begin. We have the magnitude and direction exerted by two tugboats towing a ship are 1,590 kilograms north, 35 degrees west, and 1,150 kilograms south, 55 degrees west, respectively. We need to find the magnitude and the direction angle of the resultant force. All right, so let's begin with the first vector that I'm going to call V. And we see V from the north is going to bear 35 degrees west. So that puts us here in the second quadrant. As we're bearing west, we know that's 35 degrees. Let's go ahead and label the vector V. And we know that this angle here has to be 55 degrees because we know in each quadrant it's a total of 90 degrees. With that, we need to find theta. We know that theta is going to be the angle created starting here, going all the way over to the left. In this quadrant, we know that's 90 degrees. So for theta, for vector V, that's actually going to be 90 plus 35. And that comes out to be 125 degrees for theta for the first problem here. And also, let me put the magnitude, which is 1590. All right, let's switch colors for the second vector. Let's switch that to this orange-like color. For the second vector, we're going to call that W, and we see W is moving, has a bearing of south 55 degrees west, so that puts us here, bearing west at 55 degrees. We're going to call this W. And we know this angle in here has to be 35 degrees. But for us to find theta, we need to find the angle that's created from the x-axis all the way back here. And we know this here is 90 degrees. So theta for vector W is actually 90 plus 55. But again, we have to be careful, because we're moving in a counterclockwise motion, this answer is going to be negative. So 90 plus 55 actually turns out to be 145, but we have to make that negative because of the angle in which because of the direction in which we're calculating theta to be. And I also want to put the magnitude on here. So the magnitude for this is also coming out to be 1150. Alright, let's go ahead and put this vector V where we have its magnitude and direction. So for V, actually let me do W first because I'm already in the orange color. So W, the magnitude is 1150. The direction is going to be a negative 145 degrees, and that's I, plus 1150 sine negative 145 degrees J. Okay, once we start to work this out, let me go ahead and switch to blue, and then let's do vector V. Alright, with vector V, we know its magnitude is 1590. Cosine, the angle that we found was 125 degrees I, plus 1590 sine of 125 degrees J. What I'm going to do here now is I need to find the resultant. The resultant is actually going to be V plus W. Let's switch that to an entirely new color. Let's use this brownish color here. So to get the resultant V plus W, I need to add up my horizontal components, which would be 1150 cosine negative 145 I plus 1590 cosine 125, and then I'm going to add that to the 1150 sine negative 145 J plus the 1590 sine 125 J, and I forgot the I, let's put the I there. All right, I'm going to call up the calculator, and with the calculator we're going to figure out what this resultant vector is and its I and J components. All right, let's turn it on. Let's go ahead and do the horizontal components first. So that's 1150 cosine negative 145 plus 1590 cosine 125, and we see that comes out to a negative 1854 for the I component. So here we have negative 1854 I, and now let's figure out what the vertical component is. So back to the calculator, and here we have 1150 sine of negative 145 degrees, and I'm going to add that to 1590 sine, oops, I need to back up, 1590 sine of 125 degrees. All right, with that we see that's 642 8/10, and that's our vertical component. Oops, let me verify that number. 642. So we have 642 8/10 J. Now with that, I can create a new picture of the resultant force. So let's draw another coordinate plane. On this coordinate plane, I see I need to move in a negative direction horizontally and a positive direction vertically. So that means this vector will look like so. And with that, it creates another right angle. I know that the horizontal distance here is a negative 1854, and the vertical distance is a positive 642 8/10, and the angle inside here is theta. In previous videos, I've used cosine, but in this particular video, I'm going to use sine so that you see a different trig function that can be used to solve this problem. So I'm going to use the sine of theta. Sine of theta, we know sine is the opposite over the hypotenuse. Actually, I need to figure out what the magnitude of this is first. So the magnitude here would be V plus W. So let's go ahead and do that. For me to get the magnitude, I need to take the square root of the sum of the horizontal component squared plus the vertical component squared. And again, we'll use the calculator to come to that. Okay, so let's do second so we can get our radical symbol. It's a negative 1,854, but since we're squaring it, I'm just going to put it in as a positive number, because anytime you multiply a negative times a negative, you're going to end up with a positive anyway. And then let's also square the vertical component, 642.8, and that there is also squared. And we see that the magnitude, or the length of that hypotenuse, or the length, actually the length of the resultant force, is 1,000. Let's get that number again. 1,962.3 and 3/10. That's what this here is. So we've actually figured out one part of the problem here, where they said find the magnitude. Here we just found what the magnitude is. All right, now we're going to find out what the, I need to find out theta. And I'm going to move this over so that we have, so have some more room. Like I said previously, we've used cosine to find this answer for theta, but now we're going to use sine just to see a different method. We could also use tangent, but we'll use sine. We know that sine is the opposite side, its ratio is the opposite over the hypotenuse. The opposite side is 642.8. And we found the hypotenuse, or the magnitude of this resultant force, is 1,962.3. For us to find out what theta is, we need to take the arcsine of both sides. So let's do this here, the arcsine of sine theta. And the arcsine of this division problem here. All right, when I take the arcsine of sine theta, that just gives me theta. And we're going to use the calculator to get the arcsine of the other half of this equation. So let's do second arcsine, and we're going to take 642.8 and divide that by 1,962.3. And here we find theta to be 19 1/10 degrees. So let's add this right here, 19 1/10 degrees. That there is what theta is. But for us to solve this problem using bearings, we need to find this angle here. Well, to find that angle there, I'm just going to do 90 minus the 19 1/10 degrees. And that there is going to give me 70 9/10 degrees. Now, if we're to show the bearing, we know that it's going to be north, and we're going to bear west. So this here is going to be north, 70.9 degrees west as the bearing for this particular resultant force. All right, that sums it up for this video from Spell Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel found under the name Spell Tutorial. And thank you again for watching.